Derek LeGault. I have the pleasure of working with Holly on a couple of motion picture projects, one here in New York and one many years later in Los Angeles. I'd like to begin with a phrase from The Wizard of Oz that was a favorite of Holly's, and it's when the wizard speaks to the Tin Man and says, "It's not how much you love, but how greatly you are loved in return." And judging from the outpouring of love this afternoon, indeed, Holly was very much loved by all. I attended the interment of the ashes in Hollywood and the private memorial at the Chateau Marmont in West Hollywood, and I thought they were just perfection, but I must say that this is just an exquisite celebration of Holly's life going on here today. I'm going to cut some of these remarks because they just go on, and I could speak volumes about Holly. She was a unique talent, one who did not imitate. In San Francisco, years ago, she had presented a nightclub act in which she appeared as a man, but soon abandoned this guise because, as she confided to me, "Once you create a character, that's all they want to see." She would share her insights. "I'd love to meet your mother," I said to her once. "What for? You're looking at her." In moving to California, I suspect that she had wanted to leave the past behind and make a fresh start. Once, when Jamie Gallagher was visiting, we all piled into my car and drove up Beechwood Canyon to a house where she had lived many years before, that was owned by Madonna's landscaper. And it was situated directly below a Spanish-style castle that the ambitious blonde had purchased for herself. Holly recalled how the landscaper had listed his house for sale after offering it to Miss Woodlawn, who had been renting it with another friend. But between the two of them, they could not come up with a monthly mortgage payment. This was a deep disappointment to her. Holly wanted respectability. She wanted the trappings of success, love with all the trimmings. And I can't tell you how many times she sat in my living room forcing me to play "On a Clear Day You Can See Forever," "Love with All the Trimmings," till I wanted to tear those trimmings down. But then we moved on to the barge scene from Elizabeth Taylor's Cleopatra. And I finally said to her, "Holly, must we see the barge scene again?" And she said, "Oh, just one more time." She loved it. She had conquests on her mind. When she first arrived, I joined Stiles Caldwell and Billy Edgar to visit her at a novelty store on Melrose Avenue, where she served as a shop girl. Another time, she was ringing up sales at Aaron Brothers Art Supplies in West Hollywood when Valerie Harper came into the store and asked, "What are you doing here?" "I need to keep working," she said. Always aware of her tremendous talent, she was never condescending. As recently as last October, she recalled, "And I learned from John Vaccaro what it meant to be just a little bit humble on stage."
Whoa.
No detail escaped her. After attending a high tea in London, she returned saying that she had discovered the Queen Mother carried in her purse a flask. One of the things she said to me that was a recurring theme in her life was, "Be kind in your dealings with other people. Actually, it was be kind to his gelato. Shortly before we screened East of the Tar Pits in New York, where we expected to be asked about Alexis's noticeable absence from the film. Alexis and I had been quarreling for years. Nothing seemed to please her until finally she came to see one of my plays. And, well, as Jackie Curtis used to say, we all worship at the same altar. And in these times, perhaps that slogan should appear above the doors of the United Nations. Lots of people come to Hollywood with dreams of living a glamorous life, achieving wealth and immortality. How I wish that it were so. What do we really leave behind? What do we bequeath to one another? For me, directly from Holly's lips, it's just two little words. Be kind.